This is about my son. 8 years of battle with his life.
Chadwick Lake in Newburgh, New York, is located just a few miles off exit 17 at the New York Thruway. It provides a beautiful place where visitors come to get away from the hustle and bustle of everyday life. But on June 27, 2009, it was the home of the first annual Lap for Life Walk and Run, an event to raise awareness and funds for research of desmoid tumors. The event kicks off with a 5K walk, followed by the 4-mile run, then a kid's fun run, and concludes with food, raffles, and awards. The packed gravel course, which is mostly flat with some short up and downhill gradients, takes you around this picturesque setting, providing a challenging yet tranquil running environment. But let's learn how and why this event got started.
Hi, my name is Madalena Reed, and I'm the director for Lap for Life Run Walk being held here at Chadwick Lake Park. Lap for Life was started to raise money and awareness for desmoid tumor research. 9 years ago, my brother was affected by this terrible disease, and my family and I felt helpless watching him undergo multiple surgeries, bouts of chemotherapy, and other invasive treatments. So I decided to put my passion for running to a cause, and that cause was Lap for Life. So this past December, I wrote a letter and I put it in a card, and I presented it to my brother as a Christmas gift. In it, it said, "I'm doing a fundraiser in your honor to raise money for desmoid tumor research, and it is called Lap for Life." And at that point, all I had was the name of the event, Lap for Life, my passion for running, and my desire to help find a cure for this terrible disease. I presented this to some of my friends, my close friends, to see what they thought about it. I didn't even have to ask for a volunteer. Everyone stepped up to the plate and said, "What can we do? How can we help? When can we get started?" So 6 months later, we raised over $25,000 for desmoid tumor research. We have over 430 racers, runners, and walkers here at race day, all raising money and awareness for desmoid tumors. So Angelo, this is your gift, Lap for Life, and this is your day.
Angie has an unusual tumor. It's called a desmoid tumor, one of what we call the orphan tumors. The tumors that get neglected because so few people have them, and yet it's so difficult to raise money for research. So on one hand, it's a sad occasion because he has such a tough problem, and on the other hand, of course, it's an opportunity for his friends and the people who've helped look after him to draw attention to this really difficult problem, and hopefully to raise money for research so that people with this disease don't get neglected. What they're trying to do, of course, is what many of us try to do for rare and unusual diseases. That's draw attention. It seems ironic, but it's fairly easy to raise money for common cancers like breast cancer, prostate cancer, lung cancer. It's very difficult to get support for rare and unusual orphan-like tumors.
I'm Dr. Kishore Iyer from Mount Sinai. I direct the intestinal transplant program at Mount Sinai and have in recent months been involved with the care of Dr. Angelo Casabianca, who is in fact the reason this event, Lap for Life, was organized by his very energetic sister, Madalena Reed. And it really supports a very important cause. Maybe most people who've come to this event know that Angelo underwent a fairly huge surgery with us some months ago because he was afflicted by this somewhat uncommon condition, desmoid tumor, which is a soft tissue tumor. It's histologically, under the microscope, it's a benign tumor, meaning to say it's not like a cancer, but unfortunately in some patients it can become locally very invasive and aggressive, and that was unfortunately Angelo's case.
To me, this event is just about a lot of people coming together for a good cause. Angelo is someone who's dear to us. He's my partner for 5 years. He's been my brother-in-law for 8 years. And it just means a lot for desmoid tumor research. A lot of people suffer from this disease. We're hoping that this can make a change.
It's been years since they told her about it. The darkness her body possessed. And the scars are still there in the mirror. Every day that she gets herself dressed. Though the pain is miles and miles behind her. And the fear is now a docile beast. If you ask her why she is still running, she'll tell you it makes her complete. I run for hope, I run to feel, I run for the truth, for all that is real. I run for your mother, your sister, your wife. I run for you and me, my friend. I run for life. It's a blur since they told me about it. How the darkness had taken its toll. And they cut into my skin, and they cut into my body, but they will never get a piece of my soul. And now I'm still learning the lesson to awake when I hear the call. And if you ask me why I am still running, tell you I run for a soul. I run for hope, I run to feel, I run for the truth, for all that is real. I run for your mother, your sister, your wife. I run for you and me, my friend. I run for tell you about it. If the darkness knocks on your door.
I just want to thank my sister for putting this together. It was noble, it was spectacular. It was a great event. It raised a lot of money. It's going to help a lot of people. Madeline did a hell of a job. Very happy that such a beautiful day, and you had a beautiful day, and I just can't thank you enough. God bless you. Thank you.
I run to feel, I run for the truth, for all that is real. I run for your mother, your sister, your wife. I run for you. Tell you about it. If the darkness knocks on your door, remember.